refrain from picking up meaningless detail. Such as that toy. Get this trial over with quickly. This is your client's wish, Mr. Wright. I understand. I'll do my best. It's a relief to hear that. Let's go, Espella.
Yes, Miss Darko.
I am so confused as to why... What on earth makes her want to do that? It's bizarre. The heck was that all about? You tell me.
We've been busting our butts. Right here, busting butts. They're trying to prove that Espella is innocent. She expects us just to give up now? Why are you yelling at me? Well, when you think about it, Darko's acting very strange. She is. Her own pupil's on trial, and she just stands around reading other people's newspapers. Yeah, what's she so busy reading about anyway? There's nothing about Espella in the newspaper. Is she checking the soccer scores or something? Maya's newspaper. Then we gotta read that. The break is almost over. We better go back. Flint is really confident about this witness. Who's the witness? Espella's defense journey. I'll stand him no matter what. We have to continue this trial? Oh boy. Well, we got the newspaper, I guess. Okay.
The school is hiding secrets.
Yeah, they are.
The court will now reconvene. Prosecution, is your witness ready?
Of course, Your Honor. Bailiff, please bring her in.
Good Lord, who is that?
Witness, state your name and occupation.
My name is Olivia Ardente.
Her name is Olivia Ardente.
Olive... But, oh, no. Japanese people and names, man.
The warm winds of the Mediterranean Sea carry the spicy scent of a seafood stew.
Oh, no. What is this?
A hot Sicilian stew that soothes the hearts of sailors braving the raging waters.
She casually has a weapon in court, and I agree with this. She's also got the weirdest accent.
Blessed be the Sicilian cuisine and il nostro mare.
What is this overemphasized? Oh no, come on. What is this?
Yes, Miss Ardente is employed as the cook on a freighter where the crime happens.
A cook? That's some interesting attire you're wearing.
See, that's exactly what I thought, sir. This is my work outfit. It gets very hot in the kitchen.
It's very hot in the kitchen.
It will be a pleasant change after that
chocoholic gas got up my nerves. Nice to see the judges remaining impartial.
Yes, nice to see you remaining impartial.
Miss Ardente discovered the defendant in the cargo hold where she went for supplies.
She found a speller that would make her the crew member that Johnny saw fighting with a speller? What on earth is she doing to that potato?
That's right, Mr. Wright. Miss Ardente was the first person to discover the intruder.
Then she is the victim of assault, hit with a steel pipe. How cruel.
If only I'd add...
He'd add my boss's kitchen knife.
Well, you didn't, obviously.
I'd have shown him my Ecoselle cutting skills. Excessional. Excessional cutting skills.
She's an expert potato peeler.
That's right. She's an expert potato peeler.
Better watch that around her. Yeah, sure. Keep that in mind, that's for sure.
Witness, we will now hear your testimony. Describe to us what happened in the cargo hold.
Sentimental.
Oh, no. She's got a weird... What's this weird pulsation she's doing? All right, what did you find, lady?
All right, testimony. Wait, I need to make notes. I need to make notes. Where's my notebook? The notebook! You must write down some notes.
She went to the cargo hold to check the supplies, and it was past 10 p.m. And she found the girl hiding in the clutching one of the bizarro toys. She really needs to go to the bathroom. She's just twitching. She made as if to run away. Oh, she made as if to run away, so you tried to stop her. And she grabbed a pipe. She
short, but the fiercely swung the pipe at me, tried to dodge.
She hit me in the head
and backed out a few minutes. She was blacked out for a few minutes.
According to the medical report, you suffered a laceration to your head, correct?
Yes, that is good.
She's got a potato. Just let that sound sink in for a minute. Yes, it's covered by the chef, so you can't see it now. Oh, no. Chopped up veggies. Bummer that.
Sounds most terrible.
Sounds most terrible. More careful, but she looked like a little Piccola girl? What? Much taller than this, but she is. But wait, didn't the picture before had her like looking much smaller, not taller? She's extremely tall. Well proportioned.
Prosecution would like to present.
Yes, present.
Decisive evidence.
All right, prove it. What is this? A photograph of the defendant's fingerprints on the steel pipe. Interesting. What?
You see, the fingerprints are very clear. They were left by the assailant. They've already been examined and found that those are the defendant.
Assailant is undoubtedly decisive evidence.
If what? It's not. How? Fingerprints? Are they hers, though?
Inquisitive mind at peace. No other fingerprints.
Wow.
Photograph should be added to the
evidence. Hey, we've got the evidence pool, though. If it adds to the evidence pool, we can totally use it as a defensive item.
Warned you, Mr. Wright. Further examination is but a waste of time.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Dot, dot, dots.
We asked pleading that she's not guilty, though. This witness is lying. All we need to do is expose the lie. What was she lying about?
Straight focus on the truth. What is the truth, though?
Oh, boy, it's cross-examination time, and I'm not sure what we're going to do. Name the stream dot, dot, dot beginnings. Yeah. Okay, so she makes how many statements? She makes, like, 5 statements. I don't know. The fingerprints, though. What did she say? She went to the cargo hold. It was 10 p.m. So she was there 20 minutes? Oh, no, it was past 10. She's not accurate.
She's adding,
catching the bizarro toy. So she found her already cracking into the toys, according to her statement. And then she tried to run away, so then she grabbed a pipe. Fiercely swung the pipe. Tried to dodge. Tried to dodge. Trying to dodge. What is wrong? What is evidence? Hold on. Let's go back here. What's on the evidence here? Well, correct. You wouldn't see it. Yeah, this was... Let's see here. So we got this thing. That's the PC badger. That's this. What's in the details of the photo? Oh, we can switch back. You think it's flour? Is this flour? Or is this potato oil? Or something. Like, it's got to be like flour or something. It's pretty odd. Nobody's fingerprints show up white. Like that. Like powdered white. Not at all. Like that. Please. Is that it, though? Like, I'm not so sure. What else did she say?
she blacked out, so she got hit. Fiercely saw the pipe in me. So she saw her, but she got hit in the back of the head. Still not right. This is still not right.
Objection!
Yeah, hold on. Yeah, the defendant swung the pipe at you.
That's impossible.
What do you say that?
Then his fingerprints are found on the pipe. However,
there is a contradiction.
No, a contradiction impossible.
That's most interesting. Well then, the defense shall explain.
The defense shall very well explain, and this is it. Have a look. What's in the photo? No. Have a look at what. Look at the fingerprints. Look, thumb for fingers. That would assume that she's holding it upside down. Like upside down. The position of the fingerprints, it says it's impossible because it'd be the other way around. Her thumb would be at the bottom of the pipe. It'd be the other way around. So the position of the fingerprints is wrong.
Oh, the position?
Yeah, because the pipe's upside down. See?
Yes! I'm amazing!
The defendant held the pipe like this, correct. But, hit the witness on the head, she raised the pipe like so. This is precisely what she did. Except, but here's the problem. Look where the thumbs are. So we have left, she's done just that.
You say, what are you getting at, Mr. Wright?
Have a look at the thumbprints, people.
On the pipe, in this situation, the fingerprints would look like this, but they are not.
Ah, you see? The thumbprints are indeed the other way. What do you mean? This is perfectly normal. Watch. The thumbprints are the other way around. I mean, she was holding the pipe downwards from the other end. Show small people bread. This is perfectly simple.
What?
Correct. Yeah. I'm all over this.
What is it?
You are lying, lady.
Fingerprints would have been the other way round, yeah.
Slam the table.
Something is not right with your testimony.
Nah.
Yes, I've got you now.
Objection.
Order, what is the meaning of this? These fingerprints were submitted as decisive evidence. How come this contradiction was not brought to light before?
Yeah, no.
Miss Altente.
What have you done to say? What have you done to say about this? What?
What are you doing?
One, she's throwing food in a courtroom. Two, that is a live weapon.
Excuse me, Miss Altente.
Now to bring out the full sweetness of this sweet potato. There's a pinch of salt. Interesting, right? You use salt to make something taste sweeter.
I'm not following.
And remember now, it's the other way around. Not as you'd expect it.
I'm sorry, I got a bit confused. You're normally an old pipe like that. What? She just... Never mind. She's so small, the pipe is so heavy. She held it the other way around. Yeah, she's just casually juggling in a room.
The other way?
Not like this.
How did she get the weapon?
She held it this way.
Objection!
But you testified that she fiercely swung the pipe at you.
I'm telling you, I got confused. I leave you sorry, okay?
How could you mistake the way she held the pipe? It was right in front of you.
Objection!
Oh, no, why did you go frowning? What does it matter if she held it one way or another? You wouldn't call a slightly sweeted potato a salty potato just because it's all sweet, potato, no matter what you add to it.